pandemic of COVID-19, though virtual classes had been a great blessing for children to continue their learning without a break, it has its pros and cons. So let's explore the advantages first. The first and foremost point is social distancing. Virtual classes helps to prevent the COVID spread by avoiding crowding in classrooms. Number two, convenience. Online classes can be attended anywhere and at any time, and it allows the students to learn at their own pace and schedule. Even those who are sick or disabled can attend classes regularly. Number three, it's cheaper. Since the expenses of travel, electricity, stationery, etc. are less, overall expenses to the school and students are less. Number four, I believe that the personal relationship between a teacher and a student improves as teachers are now available even after school hours for doubt clearance and personal guidance. For that, I am personally thankful to all my teachers.
Pros of online learning. Number one, increase access and reach. Online learning can be happen in any place as long as there is a device and connectivity. A physical class requires the student to come to school, but in this mode, student can study sitting anywhere in the world. Number two, no need to travel. Online, the beauty of this school is that student can study from their home, which can help us to save time, money and fuel.
Online study has become popular due to its convenience and easy operation. Online study has become trend especially during the period of COVID-19 lockdown. In 2020 and 2021, it is very convenient as both students and teachers can interact from their own places. The online study method become more useful in case of natural calamity.
Our minds go directly off the what, ifs and that cycle of thinking can be consuming and is definitely not good for our well-being.
The term online was not very appealing in 1970s and 80s, just like an aeroplane, but the development of internet played a major role in enhancement of online learning. We are in 21st century where everything is possible and online learning is one of the best examples. Online method of learning can be highly effective and alternative for the students who are motivated, mature, self-disciplined and have knowledge of time management.
Pros of online learning. First is efficiency. By using tools like videos, PDFs, broadcast, teachers are able to become more efficient educators. Now, second is accessibility of time and place. It allows students to attend class from any location. Now,
doctor, nurse, police, sweeper, cleaner, our commander, warrior, these people are fighting for us for 2 years. They are saving us by risking their lives. The whole world is troubled by this virus. Don't be afraid. Our doctor will make on its medicine on this soon.
As we know that online education is becoming more and more popular among students around the world. Although many people consider an online degree to be a lesser form of education, they would be surprised to learn and study undertaken by SRI International on behalf of US Department of Education. Pro. Means of pro, increase flexibility. The biggest advantage to studying online is increase in flexibility. You can study when you want, how you want and where you want. This does not mean the workload is less for a student studying online.
Pros of online learning. Online learning is so effective because students can finish their homework quickly and there are more time left for hobbies. Online classes can be taken from any location. Since online classes can be taken from home or the location of the student's choice, students who are not attending the offline classes through school campus, they are now attending the online classes from devices.
We worry about the past or potential future issues. This means we focus on something we cannot change or something we do not want to happen in the future. Your heart knows the way. Run in that direction. There is nothing irrational, illogical, and fearful in mind of a warrior.
Be warrior, not warrior, says our Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Firstly, I'll tell you the meaning of this beautiful and relevant topic, mostly for students and even all people. There's a big difference between them. Warrior is the person who is actively engaged in battle, conflict or warfare, a soldier or combatant, while warrior is a person who worries a great deal, especially unnecessarily.
I am a planner and I like to be prepared, and when something is unknown, it makes me uneasy, but It really is that anything can happen, and when it does, we are unequipped to deal with it. That's where this mantra really hits home for me.
Today, the whole world is facing an epidemic like coronavirus. The World Health Organization, WHO, has declared a pandemic. Coronavirus is also known as COVID-19. Corona infection is spreading rapidly worldwide.
So the biggest pros of studying online is the increase in flexibility. We can study when we want to, how we want to, and where we want to. And also, by studying online, pollution can be prevented. As we will not go to school, so we will not use the vehicles which runs on diesel or petrol that cause pollution by releasing out harmful gases.
We are all part of online learning today, and we are still trying to figure out the good and the bad parts. But it's imperative now more than ever to talk about how effective it's really been. One of the greatest benefits of online learning is that it does not need you to be physically present in the classroom. Students can study anywhere, even outside their hometown. They can also participate in multiple extracurricular activities since the time they spend on school has decreased. Moreover, shy students who actually didn't ask doubts in class are now able to ask their doubts without hesitation.
Online learning, on the one hand, has helped children to continue their studies even in the hard times of this pandemic. But on the other hand, it has more ill effects than the good ones. Online learning has proved effective only for those students who are really willing to learn and who are serious about their studies.
Don't be discouraged of anything. Nothing is like accident or coincidence. Everything which comes to you comes to teach you, comes to train you. If you have put something hard on your way, don't be discouraged by it, because it had came to teach you about the thing what is to come. If you are allowing your past experience to come up and negative up you, then how can you accept anyone of be trusting of you? Thoughts exceed from actions to actions.
Since technologies are growing and influence young learners, a secondary electronic material for teachers was developed and further for them. By preparing a lecture with multimedia materials such as song or video, teachers are now able to captive easily their intention.
According to my opinion, traditional books are always better than an e-book, because reading e-book gives strain to our mind, but a paper book never do so. E-books need internet, electricity, phone charging, battery, etc. But a paper book you can read easily without thinking such argument. While reading e-books, you may distract through ads, advertisement, or other sharing. Traditional books are meant to focus on your reading only.
Today I am going to express my views on the topic, can an e-book replace a traditional book? According to my opinion, traditional books are always better than e-book, because reading e-book gives strain to our eyes, but traditional book never do so.
So as you all know that the novel coronavirus has been spreading all over the world recently, which at the end resulted in a lockdown, as it's a communicable disease. So thus, to take proper measures, we had to stay at home and maintain social distancing and all the other proper measures for avoiding the COVID-19.
Technology is percolating in every sphere of life, including the way we teach and learn in schools. It is customizing education based on the particular strengths and interests of students. It is systematic and helpful method to improve process of learning.
E-books are not only convenient and economically, they are also much better for environment in comparison of paper books. Paper books are heavy to carry everywhere, but e-books can be stored in a single system and can be accessed from anyone.
Can an e-book replace with a traditional book? So let us begin it with an example. Zombies has attacked on our town. In this situation, your phone battery is down and internet connection is also down, and there is no electricity. So in this situation, our traditional books will just be fine.
Can an e-book can replace a traditional book? So my answer is yes.
E-books are not only convenient and economical, they are also better for the environment than proper paper books. I strongly believe e-books should replace physical books. Firstly, physical books aren't space efficient. The books have normal size has roughly 200 to 300 pages.
Be it adopting the safety way of evading the spread of coronavirus, which is too frequently key watch in our hands. It is estimated that a family of five will use about 100 to 200 liters of water only for hand washing purpose, thus increasing the daily waste water generation from each household, thereby putting a strain on the municipal treatment system. During the lockdown, most of us have stocked up a lot of food and snacks, the majority of which came packed in plastic and paper bags.